Sonic Adders, welcome back to another video. I was going to use another camera for this one, but I tested it and the audio is fucking worse. Well, no, the audio isn't worse, but it's actually the slightest bit better when it's not near the fucking of the computer. But the lip syncing is very, very off. Like, you have to try to get lip syncing that bad. So, yeah, it's just... Yeah, of course I've tested the Vita camera. The only thing which I can use right now is fucking webcam because, well, the one-touch upload doesn't work because you can't configure the thing without a computer, but the computer doesn't like it. Anyway. I guess. Anyway, so now I'm going to be blabbing on about conspiracy theories. The reason why you clicked on the video. Now these are Sonic related. I'll make proper videos when I don't have cancer audio, but let's be honest, that's not gonna happen for a very long time. So, anyway, let's go! So first, is Sonic bisexual? Well, he's certainly not gay shit. I can't believe I'm making this, but you know, this is a conspiracy theory. This isn't meant to be plausible. So first, Sonic. Let's look at the relationships he's having canon. In Sonic X, there's Amy. Inside Sonic Boom, there's hints towards Amy and that. Inside the storybook games, he's always talking to Amy at the end. In the TV shows, well, in Saturday AM, it's Sally. In the comics, mostly Sally, though there are some Amy in that. And then, of course, in Sonic 06, it's Princess Elite. So, we can say that he's definitely not gay. But is he bisexual? Well, he certainly does have a thing for other species, like, you know, he dated the squirrel, and noting that in one arc in the comics, he has children, so he's probably fucked up. Why am I making this video? Anyway, let's continue. And then, of course, there's Princess Elise, who pretty much done CPR on him, kind of magic, whatever. Who too loves Kit Elder. Yeah. So, now let's talk about his relationship with the other characters. So, of course, he has kind of a brotherly thing with Tails, so, unless they're into incest. They're definitely not going out. And then, of course, Shadow and that, they have rivalry, so, unless they're in a mutually abusive relationship, nah. You know, let's just move on to the next one. I can't keep a straight face while saying this. Alright. Did Sonic lose in Sonic CD? Well, the only thing which is backing that up is the bad future happening in Sonic 4 and Sonic Generations. You know, inside the Metal Sonic boss fight, you fight him inside the bad future, Sonic 4. Well, he's just lying there in the bad future. Is it a purposeful detail that they went, maybe we shouldn't do the good future? Because, you know, only because it's the hardest ending doesn't mean that Sonic didn't stop Chaos, or Sonic didn't stop Metal Sonic for the second time, or, you know, shit like that. And, well, that would answer a lot of things, such as, why is there an entire fucking lost planet in the sky? Like, just think about that. First off, why is it the Lost World? How did the planet get lost? How did the planet fucking get there in the first place? Well, inside the classic Sonic times, Little Planet got chained up, and that's where that crazy bitch Amy came from. God damn it. No, but... yeah. So, of course, there is that, and Little Planet only gets tethered off the chain and goes back into space at the... on the good ending. If the bad ending happens, well, it'll just stay chained up. But of course, tethering an entire planet, it's bound to just snap sometime or later, so let's just assume that Lost World just snapped off the chain at one point, and maybe, well, it's been taken over and that, because think about it, how could all of Eggman's old badniks be on Lost World if it was a lost world which none of the games occurred on before? But really think about it. And then of course there is just the whole thing of the planet being entirely abandoned and that, it crumbling off. If you know science and that, oh god, we're putting science into Sonic. That's Sonic as a whole! No, but you'll know that when one smaller planetary body is near another one and noting that Lost World can't fit inside the sky of Mobius, it's safe to say that Mobius is a fuck ton larger than Little Planet. Well, from that, basically, the closer it is, the more they attract, and when it becomes too tough, they basically start to break away and that. That would show why it has all those fucking holes in it. Like, of course, it's not gonna be full science, because, well, it's a series about a super fast furry stopping Peter's worst nightmare from turning animals into cyborgs. Yeah, so of course the planet covered in badniks from Eggman taking over, all of the inhabitants fucked off, like Amy Rose, why is she on Mobius still when she was on fucking Little Planet? But you know, she came from it. Why are they on Earth? Maybe they got sucked into Sonic Rush Tornado, you know, Rush Adventure. Yeah, but anyway, so of course there's just that whole thing. And that, wow, I spent so much time on this. This isn't even a conspiracy theory, it's just a hypothesis. But yeah. And of course, if Eggman wins and takes over the planet, well, that kind of answers how Eggman has all of those fucking materials ready to build robots every fucking day. Like, think about it. If he can't even conquer... he builds so many fucking robots. And so many battleships and shit. He has to be getting all of those resources somehow. Maybe he's just been mining out fucking Little Planet, or maybe he's taken control of Mobius and Sonic is just trying to stop him from taking over Earth, because, you know, all of his world domination attempts inside the main series has been on Earth. Like, think about it, like, Sonic 1, yeah, he is stopping him and that, he has space station and shit. Sonic 2, pretty much the same story. But no, he doesn't have a space station in Sonic 1. But you see that most of it is just natural landscapes and that. with robots going fucking everywhere. But then in Sonic 3, it's on Angel Island, somewhere off the land of Mobius and that. Like, it's still a part of it, but it's certainly not attached to it in any way, something which Eggman decided to attack separately in order to get the Master Emerald for ultimate power. Yeah. So of course in that time there could have been some kind of large scale takeover, because well, there are a lot of mechanical places inside Sonic, like, you know. What's the one main series title after the classics which appears in some kind of Mobius? Oh yeah, well, which doesn't appear on Earth, you know, that isn't just a first level city. Oh, it's Sonic Heroes. You don't see a single human type thing, all you see is just Eggman stuff, like, yeah, speed, yeah, this speed thing with lava going up, that looks like a fucking normal structure in a city and that. Yeah, and then of course Ghost House, like, yeah, there's totally buildings like that, and then of course there's the fucking battleships. There's that large mechanical canyon of that, and then there's that large fucking casino. So yeah, of course he's taken over more land, and then of course inside Russia map there's casinos type stage, there's the space station, and then there's the water park shit, and you know, there is like one or two natural bits. Yeah, not really too sure, but you get where I'm going at. And of course inside Sonic Advance there's casino levels, and then there's the mechanical thing, and then of course there's the bit where you get lifted up into the space and that. Like, yeah, a lot more mechanical shit inside it. Meanwhile inside the earthly titles, it's just mainly an Eggman land or Eggman secret base or some shit like that. Like, he has some kind of secret base hidden away, but you know, he doesn't have large fuck of casinos or, you know, large cities dedicated to him. The most he ever gets to that is in Sonic Chronicles, or no, inside Sonic Unleashed. We can't forget Eggman, man. My fucking goodness, that's one long fucking level. Anyway, so yeah. Now let's go to another theory. Sonic's age, he's 15. That's kind of, no, I should probably go slightly further in it, because, you know, something simple, that's another conspiracy theory. So, yeah. So Sonic's age, noting that everyone aged like 2-3 years, like Amy was about 10 or something, and then she bumped up in, like, classic Amy, or Rosie DeMasco was about 10, 11, and then she shot up to 13, come the modern era, or adventure era, who fuck cares. And then there's Tails, who was about 8, and then shot up to 10. Yeah, you know the pattern here. Sonic would have shot up 2 years as well, and noting that he's pretty much just, well, noting that he's 15 in most of his titles and that, and noting that he's pretty much a 90s stereotype, like, you know, cool. Yeah, reasonable age would be classic 13 more than 15. Because, well, think about it. What's a 90s stereotype? The cool kid! And what age do children think are cool for some fucking reason? The teens. And of course, with Sonic being 15 inside Adventure, where he still has some of that 90s attitude but still has some fucking character. that's a rant for another time. Yeah. And then of course classic Sonic either being a new inside generations or inside his TV shows being a nanny stereotype. It does make quite a lot of sense. And of course it makes Sonic mean plausible because, well, they're both fucking teenagers at that point. Oh my god, shit them now! But if anyone sends me fucking Sonic me or I will kill you. No. Well, really, it's certainly more appropriate than him fucking a squirrel. Like, you're from a different species? Okay. Yeah. Like double standards, people. If it's not okay for the human, it's not okay for a squirrel. I like this video. Okay. Goodbye, helicopters. Don't let the believers get you. Or they'll make you make weird ass videos. This is why you don't make daily videos, people, because you just come up with the stupidest ideas and it gives you an excuse to make them. Like, you know, I wouldn't normally make this video, but I have faculty to upload, might as well make it. Now, speaking of which, if I wanted to make it efficient, I'd have just made them their separate videos, but you know, you don't want to watch that, do you?